Joining us right now, I think we got him on the line, is our friend Congressman Jim Jordan, who has been the subject of a lot of discussion with all of the some of the stupidest stuff I've ever seen. He joins us now via phone. We know he's really busy and he's running around. And of course, Ohio's 4th congressional district. Congressman, always a pleasure. Thank you for joining us today.
You bet. Good to be with you. Merry Christmas, and thanks for all you do for the cause of freedom.
Of course. Merry Christmas. Got to ask you about these texts that you didn't write. I mean, how surprising was it to you to see like a screenshot of, you know, a three-paragraph summary of a four-page thing that some other guy wrote, and yet it was attributed to you? I know that one of the favorite phrases of the left is selectively edit. Well, I mean, what were your first thoughts when you caught wind of this, when you realized that, you know, this is actually what he was presenting? Adam Schiff was presenting in a slide and attributing it to you.
Yeah, the first thought is, well, nothing new here. It's not like we haven't seen this game before, where
especially
government
from
is
him.
Weaponized and the truth isn't presented. You know, I said this the other day. 10 years ago, it was the IRS, targeting conservatives. 5 years ago, it was the FBI spying on President Trump's campaign. And remember, in that, we actually had an FBI lawyer alter a document, mm-hmm. take it to the secret court to get the warrant so they could go spy on a presidential campaign. And then, of course, just 2 months ago, we find out that the Justice Department is spying on moms and dads across this country who are standing up at school board meetings. So I really, like, after Sean Davis wrote the piece, I thought it was interesting because it was within like an hour or so, the Select Committee puts out a statement and they say this: the Select Committee is responsible for and regrets the error. And my takeaway is that's government speak. That's government speak, Dana, for we got caught lying.
Yeah.
And we got caught changing things. And that's how they do it. So but it's nothing new with these guys. And this is, but it should tell us what we are kind of already knew.
Yeah.
How can you trust anything from this group of folks? How can you trust anything this committee says or does or puts out? So, you know, you go into court and the prosecution presents something that's not true, alters the document. Case done, case over. You can't do that kind of thing. But it seems like these Democrat politicians do it all the time.
Now, we're talking with Congressman Jim Jordan, who was the star of some selective editing by Adam Schiff, who has done this repeatedly, whether he was doing it with the telephone call between Trump and Zelensky, Ukraine's president, or mm-hmm. the Trump Jr. emails. I mean, it goes on and on. Honestly, Congressman, what scares me about this is that it doesn't matter what the truth is. They'll make something up to justify the persecution. Yep. I was telling people that they need to remember that this is what Democrats do when they're controlling a select committee. This is what they're doing with just this much power. Imagine if they had more.
Yeah. No, it's frightening. And you're right on the target. You know, think about 2 days ago. They held our friend, a good man, Mark Meadows, in contempt. And with that vote, they are actually trying to put a good man who is a good public servant, they are trying to put him in prison simply for exercising a precedent that's been around since 1794 when George Washington first asserted executive privilege. And the court has been so clear, the executive privilege doesn't exist for the president or for the benefit of the chief of staff. It exists for the benefit of the country so they can have candid conversations and make decisions so the commander in chief can get advice that he needs to get in important situations to make good decisions for the country. And they're going to destroy that all for political power. And it's the same people. This is what drives me nuts. Same people who used a so-called whistleblower anonymously. Only Adam Schiff got to know who this guy was, an anonymous whistleblower to run an impeachment in secret in a bunker in a basement in the Capitol, doing depositions and hearings there where the American people couldn't be a part of it. That now they're the ones who are going to destroy executive privilege? You got to be kidding me. That is how serious this stuff is and why in November we have got to take back the House and Senate so we can put a check on this, I think, behavior that threatens the Constitution, threatens the First Amendment and everything else.
We're talking with Congressman Jim Jordan. He's got a book out, Do What You Said You Would Do, Fighting for Freedom in the Swamp. Congressman, I don't think a lot of people realize how unbelievably important executive privilege is. You just hit up on something that is just, it's one of the many, many important pieces of this overall puzzle that is the United States, because our elected leaders need to be able to have frank conversations. And sometimes those conversations, I mean, you know, there's raised voices, there's, you know, metal iron sharpens iron. That's kind of how it goes. And you have to be able to have these conversations without the entire international world having a front row seat, because people in the press would love to cherry pick it and present it as a way to boost their own credentials, which ultimately hurts the country.
Yep. No, they'd love to do just exactly what Adam Schiff did. That's exactly what they did, what this committee did. That's what they would love to do, and that's why there is this privilege. The court is so clear when it said, we have had this so they can have the kind of conversation you just described, Dana. Candid, even harsh, sometimes even obscene kind of conversations. Not obscene, but harsh language. I'm trying to remember the exact quote from the Supreme Court. But candid, harsh language, opinionated language used. Who's going to do that unless it stays private? That's the language the court used. And again, as I said before, the court said this is there for us, for we the people. It's for our benefit, the nation's benefit. But the Democrats aren't focused on the nation and we the people. They're focused on political, scoring political points and political power and going after their enemy. And their primary enemy right here is they're going after President Trump, because they believe what I believe, that he's going to run and I believe he's going to win. And his threatening, the way he would threaten the swamp and change things, that's what they're ultimately afraid of, and that's why they're doing this.
I have to ask you, Congressman, is what I'm reading about you and Liz Cheney and some of the words exchanged, what's the truth to that?
Referring to the day of the attack?
Yeah,
I was
looking at this piece. Yeah. They're saying that, Liz Cheney's tearing into Jim Jordan over his defense of Mark Meadows, because what you just said about executive privilege and this, the reason why they're trying to go after Meadows, I agree with you. I think it's ridiculous. But what I don't understand is how we have a Republican sitting on this committee who's reading out these emails without questioning the veracity of them or questioning the integrity of the person who's presenting them.
Yeah, well, I think in light of what we found out yesterday, that they're doctoring a document, altering a document and presenting it to the American people, I don't know how you can trust anything anyone on this committee says. I mean, I think we knew it was political. Now, where if anyone had any doubts, those doubts are gone. It's obvious this thing is purely political. Because if they wanted to answer the question about the security of the Capitol, the person they need to be talking to is the Speaker of the House. And why did she not take up Chief of Staff Meadows' offer to have the National Guard there for this day? Why didn't she take him up on that? And the reason is really clear, because for the whole summer before, what did Democrats do? They attacked police officers. They were for defunding the police. They said, oh no, rioters and looters and attacks on law enforcement, those aren't anything but peaceful protesters. So when you do that for a whole summer, it's kind of hard to say, oh, we kind of want the National Guard to be here now today. For January 6th, and so she didn't do it. And there's some, I think, real questions there, but of course those are the only questions that aren't going to get asked by this political committee.
Right. We're talking with Congressman Jim Jordan of Ohio's 4th Congressional District about all these crazy, this text and this thing. And just to go back to this, because I was looking at we were playing audio on the show of people reading the text. Liz Cheney was one of those reading the text. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I am not familiar. I have not read anything where she stopped reading the text messages and then asked anybody on the committee, are these accurate? Are these presented, are these fully accurate? Anything like that done before the airing of grievances, so to speak?
I don't know. You would think there was some kind of evaluation of the messages, but look, I mean, they read them. They said, oh, at some point later, we're going to announce who these lawmakers are. I think that Mr. Thompson said that. But I think the only takeaway you can have is what I said before. Mm-hmm. How can we trust anything that comes from these guys? How can you trust anything that they say or do, or what this committee is up to, in light of the fact that first, I mean, think about every precedent they're breaking. They're trying to make D.C. a state so they get two new U.S. senators. They kick Republicans off committees. They won't let the Republicans who the leader wanted to put on this select committee. They say, no, we're not going to let you do that. First time in the history of the House of Representatives that the minority leader has not been able to put those individuals he or she has selected for that select committee. So they do that. They're trying to change the filibuster. They're trying to pack the court. They do impeachment proceedings in secret with an anonymous whistleblower that the public's not to know who this person is who started an impeachment proceeding against the president of the United States, and now they're going to put a good man in prison for and destroying executive privilege. And just to add insult to injury, the evidence we presented and the night before to say why we need to hold Mark Meadows in contempt and try to put him in prison, we altered the evidence. So those are all the norms and precedents they are breaking. This is why it's so scary when Democrats have complete control of government.
Yeah. I have one more question for you on this before we ask about, I ask you one final question about the House Freedom Caucus expansion. I was reading a headline where Nancy Pelosi is still, apparently she's still going to stay on and be Speaker of the House. And I was thinking that considering the political alliances right now in the House, I can't think of anyone that would be more of a blow to than Liz Cheney. I wanted to get you if you had any thoughts on that.
Well, she's, I mean, look, you never want to be overconfident. You know, we know that from sports and everything else, but I feel good about our chances of taking back the House in November. And I feel good about the fact that Nancy Pelosi is not going to be the Speaker of the House. It's going to be Kevin McCarthy, and Republicans are going to be in charge. And then in 2 years, it's going to be Donald Trump running for president. He's going to win the White House. And then we can really put the country back on the track that it was on just 12 months ago when things were going so well. So, with Joe Biden in the 30s, I just don't see how.
I think it's shellacking maybe worse than it was in 2010. Talking with Congressman Jim Jordan. Last question for you, sir. We appreciate your time with us. The House Freedom Caucus expansion to states. Talk to us about this, because this is I think the House Freedom Caucus has been doing a really good work and keeping some maybe moderates in line.
Thank you. Well, two things that have happened. One, we'll have a new chairman in January, Scott Perry, a great member from Pennsylvania, and you know he'll follow up. We had Mark Meadows and Andy Biggs who did great jobs as well. So Scott will be our new chairman. And then we just had this phenomenon, it's sort of organic out there, state legislatures. They're forming freedom caucuses, and the concept of the freedom caucus is exactly what the title of our book is, that I wrote about, and that is do what you said you would do. Mm-hmm. Go fight for the people who. You put your name on the ballot. They elected you. Go do what you told them you were going to do. And it's great to see that happening across the country where states are forming these organizations as well and fighting for the principles that you're fighting for every day and the principles that make our country a special place.
Amen to that. Merry Christmas to you, sir. Congressman Jim Jordan of Ohio, the book, Merry Do Christmas. What You Said You Do, Fighting for Freedom in the Swamp, and Happy New Year to you as well. Thanks for fighting the good fight. We'll see you in the new year, sir.
Thank you.
And take care.